Okay, everybody, just wanted to update you on what is happening here in Israel. Things are starting to happen. There was a rocket, of course, many of you know, rocket fell between Tel Aviv and Netanya this morning, and seven were injured, but it was a miraculous miracle that nobody was killed. But there were seven injured, and the house is completely destroyed. So right now, things are happening, and I feel to tell you that, you know, down by the people that live by the Gaza border, they've been told to stay in their homes, and that things have begun. But what I want to say to all of you that are watchmen on the wall is this scripture. Joel 3:16, the Lord will roar from Zion and will raise his voice. The Lord will roar from Zion and thunder from Jerusalem. The earth and the heavens will tremble, but the Lord will be a refuge for his people, a stronghold for the people Israel. I believe that, and I'm declaring that. And I'm declaring that even as the Lord is roaring over his people Israel, that Israel will rise up in that roar, and there will be such a victory in this hour for Israel and for the Lord's people that the earth and the nations will begin to shake, knowing that the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is the same God from when he roared and loosed his people out of Egypt. This is the end, the last few days. We had Purim a few days ago. Victory is in the camp. And I declare that over the IDF and over what is taking place. But most of all, I'm going to declare this, that as the Lord, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, roars over his people Israel, that the church in America will hear the roar and will wake up and turn towards Zion and pray for the peace of Jerusalem. That's our heart cry as Noma and I stand here in the Judean hills, standing with his people, being watchmen on the wall, not moving, not budging at all, because we know the covenant he gave with Israel. So stand with us and pray now for the peace of Jerusalem. Shalom from the Judean hills.